I used to make money, but not no more.
I got bills to pay and children who need clothes.
When you get done paying it, everybody else, you ain't got nothing.
They say these waters are in what they used to be. But I got people back online who count on me. So
the work is backbreaking. The bounty of the sea is disappearing. But still, they set out each morning determined to keep a fading dream alive. A dream passed down through the generations to live the life of a waterman.
We're being run out of here, so it's plain and simple. That's what's happening to the watermen now.
Six days a week, brothers Bubba and Jim Withrow take the Taylor Ray into the bay to search for the day's catch. They come from a long line of watermen, and today they're working with their father, Harvey.
We left the dock about 5. We went out there to take up 100 pots so I could take them home to clean them and dip them, get them ready to go back over by the end of the week.
On a good day, they gather up to 50 bushels of crabs before the sunrise. Today, there were only a few crabs in each crab pot.
We took up about 3 bushels of crabs, which ain't very good. Usually, you know, we double, triple that at least.
And about $100 worth and made nothing. That's how it'd be the rest of the week, basically.
The waters aren't nearly as bountiful as they used to be, but Bubba and Jim are determined to stay loyal to their family trade. The brothers learned early on that being a waterman isn't easy, and nature can work against you. In 2003, Hurricane Isabel ravaged the pier that their granddaddy built. The Deep Creek Public Pier has become the Taylor Ray's new home, until today, because man can work against you too. Today's the last day that they're uploading their catch here, because the pier is being torn down. The city has deemed it too expensive to repair. The day before the pier is set for demolition, Jim and Bubba move the Taylor Ray to the bulkhead across the creek while they figure out what to do next. The Taylor Ray is the last boat out.
The watermen have been consistently being run out of here through the years. And not because they wanted to leave.
It was economically.
Right.
Not feasible
right.
for them to raise their children doing what we do. All your waterfront property now has been built up. It's like the Gold Coast. If you have a 7-figure salary, you can live on the water on a hill like that. But when it rains, all those chemicals go right into this basin right here on this marsh, and it ends up being in an oyster that I'm supposed to go catch is where it ends up at. And that's the whole Chesapeake Bay watershed. That's not just here in our backyard. That is the whole entire Chesapeake Bay watershed.
My grandfather, he taught me everything I needed to know. And I brought up in the water. He started me out at 2 years old.
Well, I started going with my brother, you know, when I was real young. My dad, my mom used to go with him. And you know, every time I get a chance off school, I just take off and go with them, you know. And sometimes I even skip school and go, you know. It's just what I like to do. They woke up and nobody showed up for work. Guess what? I was going. Like it or not.
Bubba and Jim's mom, Darnette, has been working the water since she was a teenager. She and her father have passed down their knowledge to Bubba and Jim. They can't imagine wanting to do anything else.
His love is that in the water. I don't think he'd be happy anywhere else.
It's not about the money. Money don't make you happy. I mean, it's more to life than money. That's the way I feel. For me to be happy and doing something I enjoy, as long as I can survive and get by, pay the bills, then that's living.
It's the freedom of it, really, is more or less what all of us love about it. That, you know, if you want to do this, you can do it. If you want to fish, you can fish. If you want to go crabbing, you can go crabbing.
You know, the saying, whatever doesn't kill you makes you stronger. And it has. To be honest, I almost thought it would be a relief when he said one day, he said, you know what, I'm going to sell the boat. And I thought the day he said that I would be relieved, but I wasn't. It was heartbreaking. It really was. that's who he is, that's what he does, and there's no other way around it. And I would never be the one to tell him, you have to sell it, you have to stop being who you are. I could never do that.
I was a bayman like my father was before. Can't make a living as a bayman anymore. There ain't much future for a man that works the sea. But there ain't no island left for islanders like me. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Will the Withrows continue to try to overcome all of the obstacles that now face the watermen of the Virginia Peninsula? The last boat out will tell their story. Visit SeltzerFilmVideo.com to learn more about The Last Boat Out and how you can support the film and these watermen.